Utah's book banning law hilariously backfired and got the Bible banned at the elementary and middle school levels in the second largest school district in the state. Here's why the Holy Scripture is not fit for young students. The Bible is banned in these Utah elementary and middle schools now for vulgarity or violence. Davis School District's book review committee made the determination, though it's already being appealed by another parent. This comes after a parent filed a complaint in December 2022, claiming that Utah's book ban law made it easier to request that the Bible be removed from school for its sex-ridden content. How dare it? Parents thank Utah for book banning law that makes it so much easier to challenge the sex-ridden Bible. The parent in the complaint said the Bible contains incest, onanism, bestiality, prostitution, genital mutilation, fellatio, dildos, rape, and even infanticide. A review committee looked into it and decided to side with the parent on account of all those things is in there. Yeah. Christopher Williams, Davis School District's Director of Communications, said that the review committee, quote, decided to retain the book in school library circulation only at the high school level based on age appropriateness due to vulgarity or violence, close quote. The complaint was originally just to mock Utah's absurd book ban law, and now middle schoolers and elementary school kids can't go read the Bible, which if they were doing, they probably shouldn't, they should go out and play, you know, and make friends. But a little about that law. The 2022 law, which is also called the Sensitive Materials in Schools Act, bans books with pornographic or indecent material from schools and school libraries. Critics say the law unfairly targets books with LGBTQ themes and authors of color. Of course, some religious hypocrite who has no issues with kids reading about sex graphically in the Bible has challenged this new decision. An appeal was filed on Wednesday by an individual who wants the Bible retained at all school levels. Give it to the kindergartners. The district's online database for book challenges shows. But there are some hurdles before elementary and middle school kids can read the Bible in school again. And where else will they get access to it? At home? Oh yeah, there. Quote, it will now go to an appeals committee consisting of three members of the Davis School District Board of Education. That committee will then make a recommendation to the full Board of Education whether to retain or remove it from school library circulation. The board will then make the final decision. Oof, very intense, very intense. Utah banning the Bible. Is this a principled stand that will bring the end of book bans, at least in the state? Or is it a clever ploy to just increase access to only the Book of Mormon? A little twist on the story, Cenk.
Yeah, well, look, I'm gonna give Utah credit, Davis School District in particular. They offered up the banning the Bible as part gag, right? And part, well, like, yeah, we are banning books. It is one of the most violent and sexual books there is. And they, Davis School District took it seriously and they looked at the Bible, they read the Bible apparently. They're like, whoa, yeah, that's some heavy stuff, man. I don't know that middle school and elementary school kids should get it. So score one for consistency and being principled. So here on that. And if you're wondering, look, we give the Bible and Jesus a lot of credit on this show. We just talked about it in an earlier story. New Testament has wonderful parts. Sermon on the Mount is terrific. Love that Jesus threw out the money changers from the temple, etc. But it's got some troublesome parts. And the Old Testament is a horror show. Like, for example, I'll give you an example, and you tell me if they made the right decision or the wrong decision, okay? So in the Sodom and Gomorrah story, a mob comes to Lot's door and demands to rape the angels inside. We go, wow, okay, man, Sodom and Gomorrah, they had some issues, okay? And so Lot comes up with a compromise. It makes sense because he's a godly man and he's saved at the end of that story. He says, don't rape the angels, instead, rape my daughters. What? Okay. In fact, so I looked it up just to confirm, because even though I've said that story many, many times, but I wanted to find a website that talked about it, like a preferably a religious site. And I found one that asked this question. Why did Lot offer up his daughters to be gang raped? Well, that is a good question. Let's dive in, but probably not for elementary school. So I agree with Utah.
Yeah, I mean, and in that same very story, what was the city basically, because it was like Bronze Age Las Vegas, and God ended up like dumping a giant cauldron of lava onto the city, and someone turned around and turned into salt. You know what I'm saying? Like in the Old Testament, God stays destroying everybody. You know what I'm saying? They're gambling too much. There's too much prostitution going on in this town. I'm just going to murder everybody. You know what I'm saying? There's so much of that. And you pointed, I wasn't even thinking about that part of the story, which is incredibly, I mean, let's face it, that's gross. That's disgusting. That's insane. What was it? No, is it some other guy in the Old Testament whose daughters ended up getting him drunk and then sleeping with him? You know, the walls of Jericho tumbling down, was everyone in the city of Jericho evil? You know, they walked around it for 3 days. So in a lot of ways, yeah, that's right. If you want to take a look at it, like, yeah, this book has an insane amount of violence and sex in it. And like you pointed out, especially the New Testament, you can't get enough of it.
Yeah, in the Old Testament, yeah, and it was Lot's wife. And you know, people say, oh, well, she didn't listen to God who told her not to look back, right, as he was murdering everyone in the town. I'm like, okay, so a slight transgression, like, oh, hey, I wonder if I left something behind. Allah, there you go. Well, is that
salt?
Okay, it turns into salt, gone.
But the Bible is, you know, very low on gay sex. And I think, I wonder if there's something there. I wonder if that's why conservatives don't want that book banned, but they do want books that just have a sentence that says, like, Sally had two dads. That's salacious content. Please give them the book instead where the guy offers his daughters to be raped, because that's some straight sex right there.
At least you got that going. I mean, at least that, you know. So
unbelievable. They banned a book in one of the other places, not in Utah, where it was two penguins that were males that were not lovers. Because it's important that the penguins are not gay, okay? But they took care of a baby penguin together because they were decent penguins, I guess. I don't know what the morality of penguins are. But, and people are like, ban it. But the raping of the daughters, etc., oh, totally okay. And by the way, here, I'll give you another one, because there's endless in the Old Testament. So at one point, God tells the Israelites, hey, go trick another tribe. I forget which tribe. And tell them, okay, you can have our daughters, okay, as long as you do circumcision. And the minute they do get rid of their foreskin and they're in tremendous pain, they'll be weak. Go murder them all. And they did. And God's like, way to go.
The story of Job. I'm just going to destroy his life for fun.
Okay. Look, guys, there's you can take wonderful things out of the Bible. You can take terrible things out of the Bible, okay? But when you start banning books, the Old Testament's got to be near the top. I mean, if you're worried about the children, what about children? Would you talk to your children about any of this stuff, right? So keeping it real, but so did Utah. Again, no, credit to them.
No, Cenk. No, the Bible does not have penguins getting along. And I don't know if we could deal with that. Plus, part of the ban must have been that a penguin itself is black and white living in harmony, and nobody wants that. And who supports anything good?
Yeah,
absolutely not.
Is there a penguin heaven? Is there a lion heaven? And do you get into it for eating more animals or less animals?
Okay, all penguins go to hell. All penguins go to hell.
You write that book, it'll be in every red state. It's the first thing they should give you in the library. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.